So in the last lecture, you learned how to use the typography in Angular material. In this lecture, I'm going to show you how to customize this typography. So first, we want to replace the Roboto font with a different font. Let's go to fonts.google.com. Here, I'm going to search for the Open Sans font. This is a very popular font that you have seen in a lot of websites out there. It's absolutely beautiful and modern. On this page, click this font, and then click this icon here. So we selected the entire family of Open Sans. In your application, you may want to get a subset of the font instead of the entire font family. And this is purely for the optimization. But in this demo, it doesn't really matter. Now let's click on this black bar, and then click on this icon. So here on this page, you can see how to use this font in your applications. So simply copy this URL. Now back in styles.css, I'm going to replace the Roboto font with this Open Sans font. So delete and then paste the address of the Open Sans font. Beautiful. Now we need to go to our custom theme and set this font as the new font. So what we're going to do is very similar to how we defined a custom theme. So to make this code a bit more readable, I'm going to add a comment here. Define a custom theme. So all these lines are about defining a custom theme. And then define custom typography. So I'm going to start by defining a variable called app-typography. And as the value, I'm going to call a function called mat-typography-config. Once again, to better understand this function, we can simply go to the Angular Material theme file and search for this function. So look at the parameters of this function. We've got font family, which is by default set to Roboto. And then we have these labels here, display 4, 3, 2, 1, headline, title, subheading, body, and so on. These are the classes that you saw earlier in the typography documentation on Angular Material website. So if you want to further customize one of these classes, like title or body, then you need to pass additional arguments to this function. And if not, you can see all these have default values. As an example, look at the configuration of our headline. So here we have a call to mat typography level function. And these three arguments determine the font size, the line height, and the font weight. Now, to customize the font, I'm going to pass this first argument here, font family. So back to our custom theme. Here I'm going to pass a few arguments. The first one is font-family. And I'm going to set this to Open Sans. And also, as a good practice, we should have fallback fonts. So if the client cannot download this Open Sans font, we should use fonts that are always available on various machines. For example, back in Angular Material theme, you can see after Roboto, we've got Helvetica New and Sans Serif. Helvetica New is available on pretty much all Macs out there, and Sans Serif is available on Windows machines. So we can simply copy this part from here and add it as fallback fonts in our font family. So if you want to change the font, that's all you have to do. Now later, I will show you how to customize the font size and font weight as well. So we have a new object here, app-typography. Now we need to use this custom typography object, exactly like how we defined a custom theme object here, and then we included that by calling this mixin. So very similar. Now we have a custom typography object, and to use it, we're going to include a predefined mixin that is angular-material-typography. Look at the names. The mixin we used earlier was Angular Material Theme. The mixin we're using now is Angular Material Typography. And as the argument, we give it this app dash typography object. So that's all we have to do. Now back in the browser. So what you see here is the Open Sans font. Now let me show you how to customize the heading. So here in mat typography config function, we can pass another argument. Let's go find the name of this argument. So back in the main theme, we have headline that is used for H1 elements. So I'm going to simply copy this line here, paste it, and change these arguments. So the first one is font size, the second one is line height, and the third one is font weight. So let's make this font a little bit bigger, let's say 35 pixels. And also I want to make it bold, 700. We don't need this comma here. And this is how we customize our headlines. And this is our new headline. So you can see it's really easy to customize the typography in Angular material. We simply define a new typography object by calling mat typography config function. And then use this object by calling Angular material typography mixing. Again, you don't have to memorize anything. All of this is documented on Angular Material website.